on the starting group for the Grizzlies. Morant and Brooks manning the backcourt. Jackson and Valanciunas, they're in the middle. And it's Winslow in at the small forward. And for the Heat, they've got Jimmy Butler, Jay Crowder out there with Adebayo. Then there's Dragic, and it's Iguodala in at the two guard. Greg, obviously, we're early on here. We already have seen some second-year players looking much more improved over their rookie year.
I mean, if you put in the work, you're not guessing as much. And listen, the fact that you've now gone through the season, you've got a better sense of who you are.
Improvement for the Heat. Boykins checked in. Kelly Olynyk comes in for Jay Crowder. Tyler Hero, he's checked in for Jimmy Butler. Robinson is subbed in for Andre Iguodala. So Memphis going with almost an entire new group here. Brandon Clark, he's checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Anderson comes in for Justice Winslow. Junior's checked in for Brooks. And Tyus Jones subbed in for John Morant.
And seeing Junior out there again, I was impressed with his time on the floor in his debut. Showed that he could pick his spots and contribute to this team.
Junior did not miss a beat when he came into the game, did he, Greg? Exactly the debut this team was hoping to see from him. It's hauled in by the Heat. They defeated Indiana in their last game.
And that one was all about offensive execution, running your plays, picking your spots.
As long as you do that, you put yourself in a good position to win, no matter if you're home or away.
Out left to the wing, and Robinson wide open. He shoots. That's in, coming off an assist from Dragic. Dragic has got his third assist on the night. Jones, the pass to Junior. Kicks it out to Jones. Pass to Junior. Lock at six. Anderson outside. Misses off the left iron.
Oh, he found the open space from mid-range. Just maybe rushed his release a little bit.
Robinson, that's good. Here's Jones. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. There's the pass to Junior. Shoots from the baseline. Does not find the basket. His second miss. He's now 1 for 3. Right wing. Here's Hero. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Memphis trailing here. Jones, the pass to Jackson. Knocked away. Outside Robinson. The dish now to Boykins. Here's Dragic. His shot is good. Scores his third basket in 6 tries. Shooting 50%.
On the drive, Dragic's footwork really shines. His ability to make quick moves around the defense gets him to the rim.
He gives up a lot of size to most other power forwards, but not too many of them can fly like he can.
Against Jones. Hoggins left side.
That's a break for the D right there. I mean, he takes advantage of open looks inside more often than not.
And the call on the shot sends him to the line.
Really, the right play defensively. If you can't block, force him to the line.
The Grizzlies have had 2 chances at the line already, making them both.
And their free throw percentage as a unit last year, 76%, right around the middle of the road.
Cobbies checked in for Memphis. Here's Dragic. This 1 for 3. And again, Miami with the triple.
And how about the court awareness there? Dragic, fantastic job spotting the wide open teammate.
Jones looking for an opening. Passes it to Cobb. Anderson trying to free himself up. And there's Cobb. That's good on the assist by Junior.
Man, he's got such a great touch and feel around the basket. He made that reverse look easy.
Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. Plenty of space. The rebound by Anderson.
Oh, that's one of the few times they'll get away with leaving him that wide open.
And the dunk by Cobb. And a look at the number one overall pick in the draft, Hendrix Cobb, an incredible athlete who has the potential to be a game changer for this team.
Born in New Jersey but grew up in Louisiana, Cobb has been used to the spotlight for a long time. He has all the tools to be a superstar in short order.
It's his first trip to the line.
And he was dialed in at the line a season ago, 87%.
Up going with the new group. Taking a look at the Grizzlies. Jackson and Valanciunas, they're in the middle. Junior's out there with Morant, and it's Brooks in at the small forward. Three-pointer, Crane's the three-pointer. Brooks has got the lead up to nine now for the Grizzlies.
Showing how lethal he can be from there. Brooks, oh man, if you keep giving Brooks these type of looks, he's gonna keep making you pay.
Iguodala against Morant. Iguodala kicks the butt. Just five on the clock. Nice D from Brooks.
And hard work on the glass. Once again, guys, they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard. And taken with the 30th pick back in 2011, Jimmy Butler went from 15th man in Chicago, riding the end of the bench, to franchise player in the course of four seasons.
Loads it up for Adebayo, an emphatic LU jam.
With strong athleticism, Adebayo can finish just about any lob with his large catch radius.
Here's Junior. Another shot. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
Yeah, second chance points again, a huge problem for this team.
For Memphis, they have shot 6 of 7 at the line. That's good from Jackson. And Greg, it seemed in Chicago and Minnesota maybe, Jimmy Butler wore out his welcome. Philadelphia, they had him, and they had to juggle multiple stars. But, man, Miami, the Heat handed him the keys, and he has taken off.
And, Kevin, he's shown himself worthy, lifting them to a top seed in the East and himself into the MVP conversation. They've won the rebound battle so far, and it's translated to the scoreboard.
Bro, they look like they just wanted more right now. You gotta love the hustle.
And they double up Morant. To the paint, stolen. The kick outside to Butler. And there's the whistle. 3-second violation.
Costly error there. We'll see how they rebound from that miscue.
Man, when you're playing from behind, that's the last thing you want to do. Make matters worse.
And a chance there to look back at the stunning Mobile One block a moment ago.
Determined to protect the lead with the all-out effort defensively. Superb anticipation on the block.
Junior the pass to Jackson. He gets it in there.
His teammates keep getting him the ball in his favorite spots. He's done a lot for his shooting percentage.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Double team on Adebayo. Jackson against Crowder. Outside Butler.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Pass to Jackson. Out to the wing, beyond the arc. And Junior gets it to go on the assist by Jackson. Junior's got 6 points. And Junior coming into the NBA from college ball wasn't the top recruit from his class, Greg, but he showed what he can do.
Junior had some fantastic performances during his college career. Nobody was quite sure where he would land in the draft. This team's convinced that he can be a factor in the NBA.
Hey, Greg, if you could coach one team right now, who would it be?
That's a tough one. Clippers, Lakers, Bucks. You know what? I would probably go Lakers or Bucks because you would. would have an opportunity to coach someone who arguably might be considered the best to ever play the game. Because I think Giannis is trending in that direction, and LeBron obviously already is.
How about a guy like Kemba Walker and coaching the Celtics, having him to do what you want to do on the floor?
He'd be brilliant. And yeah. Kemba, one of the most underrated leaders in our game. Great, great human being.
The Heat trail by 17. Iguodala, right side. Stolen by Brooks.
And that's sort of a picture of what not to do on those last two possessions. They're being way too loose with the ball. Yeah, the D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been from beyond.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. Now, Ja Morant says in an era of five-star recruits, he was a no-star recruit coming out of high school. And that put that big chip on his shoulder. Now he has "Beneath No One" tattooed on his arm. He says, "My dad always told me that I was trained to go. Basically, that I'm built for the moment." And guys, his time is now.
Sure is, D.A. Thank you.
Just can't find the touch this quarter. He's got to keep grinding to get the best shot possible.
And Bam Adebayo demonstrating a refined skill set that belies his nickname. Over 5 assists per game. He's a creator, not just a finisher.
And the Heat have given Adebayo the leeway to rip and run, baby. Make things happen.
And Kevin, an unselfish player who loves to pass. Even back in high school, playing with lesser talent, he made sure to find the others.
Junior the pass to Jackson. And the shot is good. Jackson's got 9 points now in the quarter.
A really strong second quarter in terms of scoring the basketball.
Outside Robinson. Here's Dragic. Yes, that goes in.
And despite the hot start from beyond, they've gotten away from shooting the triple.
Brooks outside. He kicks it to Junior. Dragic against Morant to the left wing. Here's Junior. Rebound by Butler. And so it's Butler with it. He'll bring it up for the Heat. Down by 15. This, of course, their first opportunity to play Memphis this season.
And really, this is a team that expects to beat everyone when they step on the floor, but they were only able to split the series last year.
There was a good back and forth between these teams last year, if you remember. You'd expect it to be a mismatch on paper, but it turned out to be pretty even.
And the Grizzlies with some changes. Anderson, he's checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Cobb comes in for Brooks, and Jones subbed in for Morant.
Well, I think Junior's big X factor has always been his natural ability. It seemed like there's nothing he can't do and no upward limit to his athleticism.
Adebayo kicks to Robinson. That's in, coming off an assist from Adebayo. Adebayo's got his 3rd assist on the night. Pass to Cobb. Back to Jones. Some nice passing there by Memphis. Anderson passes to Junior. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. Junior's got 13.
And he delivers another blow. Something's gotten into him this quarter. He's carrying them offensively.
Olynyk can't hit.
And we haven't seen them get to the line as much here in the second quarter. They might be settling a tad too much offensively. Good eye from Cobb. Spotting the wide open man, sets it up perfectly with that pass.
Butler kicks to Robinson. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Robinson's got 6 points in the quarter. And so it's Memphis with a side. Thank you, David. And we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit. We've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this. We're getting ready for Miami. Boykins checked in. Kelly Olynyk comes in for Jay Crowder. Tyler Hero, he's checked in for Butler. Robinson is subbed in for Andre Iguodala. And that one misses. Your son, Cole Gregg, was one of the top high school players in America. A lot of services had him number one. Talk about what it was like going through the recruiting process as a dad.
You know, it was fun for the most part because he really kind of kept everything in perspective. And the teams we dealt with, the schools we dealt with, man, they were all top-notch. So that process, about as enjoyable as one could ask for. But at the same time, it's still stressful, man. That's still your little guy getting ready to head off to college.
Well, you're a dad and a proud one at that. Robinson is out there with Dragic. Then it's Olynyk, and it's Boykins in at the five down low. That's the group in the game for the Heat.
Great job of screening there. Nice job to take it to the rim and get the finish.
Memphis leading by 13. Clark dishes to Junior. So the wing on the left. And it's out of bounds. The Heat will take it the other way. Miami's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Robinson passes to Boykins. Back to Robinson. And the foul called on Junior. So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line to shoot two.
And not the guy you want to send to the line. He has been automatic.
He's made one and missed one so far in the game. Greg, you know, we're seeing players take control of their free agent destiny. Do players get a bad rap for that and switching teams?
Listen, I don't know if you get a bad rap, but you're going to catch the wrath of the fan base. You think of Paul George in Indy or KD in OKC, and fans, they're going to feel guilty. There's no doubt about it. They're going to feel scorned.
Yeah. Now the pass to Hero. Inside, it's stolen by Jones. Pushing it up. A finish. And the dunk by Kahn.
Well, with the flair that Kyle plays with, it's so fun to watch. I mean, he's a mean dude.
The Heat trail by 15. Robinson kicks to Dragic. Back to Robinson. Passes it to Olynyk. And that's good. Robinson picking up the assist. Olynyk's got his first 2 points. Memphis has gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Clark inside. Robinson on him. They get it back. Launches a three, and he trains the three. Good-looking shot there from Junior. Junior's got 5 points now in the quarter. And it's Dragic with the ball for the Miami Heat. It's a 16-point game. And here's the fast break. And then Clark slams it in.
Well, I love this dish from Junior. Anytime you see a teammate with an easy bucket, you always give him the rock.
Dragic against Jones. It's Dragic with the drive. Good. Dragic has got 16.
Oh, he's got a role in this quarter, taking it on himself to guide their offense.
Memphis leading by 16 to the inside. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And not backing down from the physical defense. Junior embraces taking on these challenges.
Crowder, he's checked in for Goran Dragic. Jackson, he's checked in for Memphis. For Miami, they've gone 7-12 from the floor since coming out of the break. Pass to Robinson, and the foul called on Junior. That's his third foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for two. He's made 3 of his 4 free throw attempts in the game. Robinson hits them both.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
Memphis has gotten a lot of looks from outside tonight. 5 of 12. Here's Clark. Lee Baz was put in just the right spot. 9 points for Brandon Clark.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket coming off a free.
They get a hand on it. And stolen by Junior. And here we go. Fast break. Junior's got it. He shoots again. misses from short range.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Crowder, that shot is off. Now the Grizzlies take it the other way. They'll be playing host to Chicago for their next game. That'll be the first of two straight at home. And that one's good, Junior.
Well, with the role he's on this quarter, they're going to keep going to him. Get that lead even bigger.
The Heat trail by 21. Pass to Boykins. Here's Hero. Outside for Robinson. From past the arc, the Grizzlies pull it in. Jackson's got his seventh rebound here tonight. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And one of the biggest surprises last year for Memphis, Brandon Clark, brought not only the energy, the...
So no problem for Memphis as they get the win. A resounding victory for them. And Greg in enemy territory, no less.
That's exactly right. But with the way they controlled the game and just completely took the crowd out of it, that's how to get it done on the road.
And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Chris Weber, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.